Today we are going to do Yashta Masa meditation. We are on the Amavasya part of this meditation. This meditation is a series of sidereal spiritual karmic healing meditation. Every year, you can do, in a new moon like today, meditation relating to the month, and in the next 15 days, the full moon, Purnima meditation. In this way, every year, we can go and renew our spiritual growth, our spiritual journey. All these meditations are available in the playlist in the description of the video. Let's take attention of the breath and surroundings. Every time that the air comes in, we move along the tube of the nose, making a U-turn inside the skull and going down to the base of the spine. When it reaches the bottom, it moves upward up to the skull, makes a U-turn and goes out through the nose. Observe the natural movement making this kind of one number, coming in, making a turn, going down. Coming up, making the turn, going out. And observe the air continuing going out. One hand, one arm distant from the tip of the nose. The air comes in. If it's natural, let it be a kind of morning sun rays illuminating this journey. And when the air starts to move out, just like a sensation of sunset. One is bringing energy in, the other is bringing the energy out and purifying the system. Keep the track of the road, the trail, the number one that is being cleansed and revitalized. If you feel comfortable with mantras, during the incoming process, we can use the sound so and in the exhalation in the mental level. Now, we are going to continue the previous journey of Vaishakha Amavasya. Let's open ourselves the process of disincarnation. Today, we are going to let ourselves to remember the process of disincarnation. Emotions may come. If they come, keep your presence in the breath throughout them. Let them rock you, explode you, whatever you being. Supported by the breath, and at the same time let them be and also let them go. Stay centered in the mantra, stay centered in the light, and let the emotions be decompressed. In this moment, we invite the guidance and protection of our spiritual mentors, gurus, guiders, healers, so that we can experience the spiritual releasing of the death of the body. A kind of fear would be natural. Some sensations in the chest, maybe in the gut. But we are going to relax and we are going to, just like when we learn to float in the water, we are going to release a little bit of the fear through the breath. Just like a feather, when this body dies, little by little, the energy starts to be lighter. If you feel like laying down during this meditation, it's okay. Initially, let's observe the body, the astral body, like 1-2 centimeters from the physical body. Physical body is still warm, but it's already dead. The astral body is slightly disconnected to the physical body. One, 2 centimeters. For some minutes, for some hours, astral body is just being close to this friend that hosted him for some time. Observe the sensations, emotions. After some period of time, the physical body is not warm anymore. And the astral body gets lighter. It will be staying for a kind of 1 hand distant, 1 arm distant. In your own size body size. If you want to have a more physical impression of this, you can put your thumb in your heart and open one hand and see the distance, and then stretch the arm with your hand open and see the distance. Now the soul is above the body. This kind of what? 10 to 50 whatever centimeters or less. Let the experience be with lying down perception. Astral body is disconnecting with a lot of emotions. The Manomaya Kosha is being disconnected. All the chakras are closing in the body, in the physical body. And there is time going to complete this process. There might be some sensations, some emotions, some feelings. If any sadness come, let it cry. Let it dry. Once again, part of our consciousness now is in the breath, cleansing the number one, coming in, going down to the bottom, coming up, and making the turn out. While another part of the consciousness is dealing with this feather that is floating. It's acceptable to be like a piece of feather in the process of disincarnation. As the process of closing the chakras in the physical body is completed, the feather of the astral body lights up more. It goes up to the distance of your body height. It can be, I don't know that in feet, but whatever, 1.6, 7, 8, 9 meters distance from your body to to be around 5 to 6 or 7 feet. Your body. Let this feather be there. A big space is now being healed, is being enlightened. Just let the attention be. In this space with the breath. This distance, a lot of concepts, a lot of rights and wrongs, are being dissolved. Some memories of the life are going to come because of these rights and wrong. And here, they are going to die, fortunately. Liberation from thousands and thousands of rights and wrongs. Them come and die. During the process, be with the breath. Keeping the awareness in the space from the lying down body to the body height, distance. Now, the feather with less rise and wrongs can go up. spiritual carriers are now able to take this minute presence of matter higher. If you see them as angels or whatever, just let the energy move upward and upward and upward. This energy is being taken to a place of rest. Place of reconnection. Divine light is being infused in this particle. Recharge. Divine light. Recharging. Its presence within this sparkle of divine light. Om. Now that the upward movement is full of light, the desire is already there. Desire to serve is recharged. The karmic process is already being assembled around this desire. And with this assemblage of karma, this spiritual seed again starts to get heavy. The angels bring it down again, connecting with karmas that are going to be the instrument for the desire of service. And when a certain magnetic field creates a lot of material presence, the angels release us and we start to be again in the realm of pre-incarnation.
Shanti.